Okay, too dangerous for jail and incompetent to stand trial.
So the man accused of murdering his newborn niece won't face a jury anytime soon. News 5's Laura Borchers is live with what Lanny Steinoff is now facing. Laura?
Jack and Cherie, the judge ordered him to go to a psychiatric hospital in Columbus until he's well enough to stand trial here. Also mentioned today, his propensity for violence here at the county jail. Rosalyn Steinoff was just 1 month old. Her 24-year-old uncle, Lanny Steinoff, asked to hold her, minutes later beating the baby in the family's Coleraine Township home on July 12th.
We had the Norcott Chill cops here, I think county detectives, the Cincinnati crime scene.
Neighbors say it wasn't Steinoff's first demonstration of violence.
I seen him earlier that day. He was just like walking around all weird. Then he got in his car and drove off and came back.
In June, he killed his dog. Police uncovered blood in his basement, over his car, and on his clothes. Doctors began treatment with Steinoff, but shortly after being released, police say he killed the baby, making gravely clear the severity of his mental problems.
My heart goes out to that family.
Jean Clark doesn't know the Steinoff family, but she knows what it's like to care for a loved one suffering a mental illness.
One in three people are affected with mental illness nowadays.
So Jean and her husband turned their painful experience into a support group for others like them.
So they have a comfort and they have an outlet.
Modeled after a class she took.
It teaches you how to live with someone or help that loved one.
Tonight she offers prayers and an invitation to the Steinoff family and to others in the tri-state like them. Now she says that sharing in the group has led to a lot of healing for her family and for others. We've provided a link on our website if you'd like to learn more about that. That's WLWT.com. Now, because of Steinoff's violent past, he will be spending his time in a maximum security mental health facility. Reporting live, I'm Laura Borchers, News 5.